Hey, Vinyl Community, it's Mazzy here. And some of you have entered my 100th anniversary, 100 subscriber photo contest. And I'm going to delay it a little bit only because I have to fly down to San Francisco and tomorrow until next week, because this is a little emotional for me. One of my closest best friends, who actually hired me at a record store in San Francisco when I was 19 years old, is in the hospital with lung disease. So I'm gonna be visiting him, so I'm gonna postpone the announcement of who wins. But in the meantime, I wanted to do one more video and just do another showcase to a photographer that I admired as a photographer. I knew him as a person for many, many years, a little tempestuous in so many ways, and I might share some stories, but I want to show you some of his work. His name is Jim Marshall. Jim Marshall lived in San Francisco. Jim Marshall was a son of a bitch motherfucker, and Jim Marshall was an amazing photographer, and really, when it came down to it, a pussycat at heart. He had basically he's one of those people that his bark was louder than his bite. And I first met him in 1980, through one of my close friends' father was his attorney that handled him in some gun weapons charges. Big cocaine addict for many years. Got put in a work furlough program. Photographed the inside the cover of the Woodstock album. A lot of jazz albums, a lot of country albums. Always carried around his neck at least one or two Leica cameras. And if I get into it, I might share a couple of stories. When he passed away, I wrote a blog, maybe I'll link it here later, of three stories about Jim Marshall. I think he died about, 10, 12 years ago now. Anyway, the first thing I showed was from this Johnny Cash book that came out last year, about a year ago, a year and a half ago. An amazing friggin' book about the Folsom and San Quentin shows, and he was the only photographer on site. But obviously, the flip-off picture has been stolen a lot for T-shirts and posters and things. And Jim wasn't afraid to have his attorney sue people for copyright infringement. And for many years, he made a shitload of money on people ripping him off in the world of copyright. But anyway, you know that image, and I'll start out, since you know that image, I'll start out with the images that sort of relate to that. The Companion Prison Albums, photographed by Jim Marshall. Great, great stuff. He did a lot of stuff in the early 60s to mid 60s, into the 70s, into the 80s somewhat, and then basically he kind of relied on his stock photography. He did some shoots, but would be around San Francisco, hitting up women, buying them drinks. You know, every time you'd see him, he'd say, "Hey, fuck you, Maslow, how you doing?" Whatever. In fact, one time, I have my own agency, I'm a photography agent, and I remember one time years and years ago, I ran into him, we were having drinks, and I was going to New York to show work of the photographers I represented. He goes, "Hey, why don't you take my work to New York, you know? Man, why don't you take, I got great photography." And I said, "Jim, I would represent you in a minute if you were dead." And he goes, "Ah, fuck you, Maslow," because he has the most amazing catalog of images of musicians, jazz, country, rock and roll. So I'm gonna show you some of his images and a few of the books I have of his. Some of the images you'll recognize, I don't have, on album cover form. One is this famous picture of Bob Dylan rolling a tire down in Greenwich Village. You know the shots of Woody Allen, Jim Marshall, The Doors, you know, Jim from the, Jim Morrison. There we go. Actually, I own that print in my collection as well, Woody Allen. Dwayne Allman. In fact, I'll go to that next. You obviously know this infamous cover he took of the Allman Brothers. And then in the reissue CD, there was a color version of this. In the box set of the vinyl, there are two outtakes of Jim Marshall's work. Great, great, great stuff. In terms of the San Francisco scene, he lived in San Francisco for years. You know his work for the cover of Moby Grape's first album. He did photograph the Grateful Dead, Jefferson Airplane. In fact, there's a famous photograph of all the San Francisco groups of 1967-68 taken in the Panhandle near Golden Gate Park, and it's a group shot, a family shot. I don't think I have it handy, but of all the San Francisco bands. Yeah, he did this cover, Jefferson Airplane. He was the main photographer at the Monterey Pop Festival. And he took the famous shots of Jimmy at the Monterey Pop Festival. Did a lot of jazz and R&B covers. Ray Charles. Another very famous Miles shot. And I happen to own three of his photographs. I have two here. He photographed the Beatles at backstage at Candlestick Park during their last concert, 1966, August 29th. And I do have a picture of John Coltrane, and this is when he recorded the Ballads album. But there's a lot of great books. This is one of his books, Not Fade Away. Here we go. But great, great, great stuff. A crazy guy, lunatic, but a pussy at heart. You'd be out and he'd buy everyone drinks. Again, especially the girls. That's a young picture of him. But he always had a Leica around. This is a great, great book too. If you're into jazz, great thing of the Monterey Jazz Festivals. Year after year after year. So as you know, if you've been listening to my videos and watching them, you know how much I'm into photography, and I do have a mini collection of some other rock and roll and jazz photographers. Again, you know who that is. Steve McQueen, right? Big jazz fan. Anyway, I think that's it for now. I don't know what else to say, but Jim Marshall, you'll see his name on a lot of album covers. Check out his books. Again, the Jazz Festival book is amazing, as is the Johnny Cash, The Prison book. So I'll see you guys in about a week, and then I'll look over all the rest of the, I think I've seen them all. There's a couple I keep coming across of the photo contest, of the 100 subscribers photo contest. As a reminder, if you still want to do it, pick one photographer, three album covers he or she has done. And again, bonus points, and I don't know, I guess if I pick the bonus point one, I'll throw something in. I was throwing a sealed copy of the Beatles Revolver, Beatles Rubber Soul in stereo. Maybe I'll put one of the art books in too. If the same photographer did three album covers by the same artist, musician or band. But thanks for paying attention. That's one of my favorites. That's a Richard Avedon. Richard Avedon was a great fashion photographer from the late 40s, 50s, 60s. He did the psychedelic posters for Look magazine that's what this session was from, with John, Paul, George, and Ringo. And I have a set of them here that I sent away for in 1967. I think it was like maybe $10 and you get all four of them. You send to Look magazine, or in Germany, you would send to Stern magazine. Anyway, that's it. Miles Davis is playing in the background from the album I showed you, The Boxing Ring. Take care. Thanks again. Mazzy out.